So how do you decide when to stay home or keep your kids out of school? Dr. Al joins us now live from Kokona with more. Hi, Dr. Al. How are you?
Hi, guys. By the way, happy Valentine's Day, a day late. Since our last episode an hour ago when we talked about the flu and a sore throat, Tom was in the office, happens to be a patient. I just grabbed him. I said, come on, you got to be on TV. And I didn't give him a choice, so he didn't have time to doll up or anything. But listen, his symptoms are exactly what we talked about earlier. He felt good on Sunday. Yesterday, boom, this hit him really fast, sore throat, aching all over, chills and a fever. He doesn't have the burning in his chest, doesn't have a bad headache. So what we're going to do, I looked in his throat, let's see, open really wide, and it looks perfectly fine. Not that you could see that on camera, it looks good to me. Doesn't necessarily mean anything. Strep throat can come on fast and can look normal on an exam. But influenza can also kind of be sneaky with how it appears as well, as we had talked about last hour. So what I'm going to do when we're finished is I'm going to check him for strep and I'm going to check him for influenza, because as he said, I've never had a flu shot and I've never had the flu. Well, first time for everything. So we will get that taken care of and we'll see what he's got. My hunch is he's going to be negative on both, and we're just going to say it's a viral infection, which is doctors speak for, well, we don't really know what you have. Take some Tylenol and go home to bed for a few days, which is probably what I'm going to tell you. Which reminds me of the other topic we're supposed to talk about today, which is not to ask your doctor for antibiotics.
Yeah, why not? Colds, because sometimes they make you feel good.
No, you think they make you feel better, but they really don't. If it's a bacterial infection, if it's strep throat, absolutely it'll help. If it's a bacterial infection, antibiotics help. But if it's a virus, antibiotics do nothing. And there were, I think, 15 million office visits last year for sore throats. At least that's the statistic I read this morning, which I think is low. And of that, a high percentage is treated or are treated with antibiotics, and it's not strep. Antibiotics don't do anything if it's not strep. Coincidentally, people get better because they were getting better and then started the antibiotics or whatever, but you should not go into the doctor's office expecting or demanding an antibiotic. It puts a lot of pressure on you, puts a lot of pressure on the physician. There's a lot of social interaction, thinking, oh my God, my patient's going to be upset. They spent all this money on an office visit or a deductible, and they're not getting a prescription. And that's a lot of doctor-patient social interaction, I should say. And so it's better to go in not thinking you're going to get an antibiotic and to be treated appropriately. And believe me, over the years, I've cut my use of antibiotics way, way, way down. And I spend more time telling patients why I'm not giving them an antibiotic versus just taking the 3 seconds it takes to write a prescription. That's the easy way out, but not the right thing in most cases.
All right. Good information,
so
Dr. Al. Now get back to
office.
Your patient. He needs you.
Yeah, well, we'll treat him probably without an antibiotic. I'll see you guys.
Okay, thanks, Dr. Al. Great advice.
Thanks.